bookstore. Welcome to Blissful Books. Yes, our policy here is to make the orders online and then to come on in and pick up your purchases. Yes. Okay, may I have your name, please? Great class. you mentioned that you like adventures, romantic adventures, or just plain out adventures. And this is, has it. If it's anything like the movie, and I'm sure it's much better than the movie. This was written by Alexandre Dumas. And it says, one for all and all for one. So if you've ever wondered where that saying came from, it came from the Three Musketeers. The battle cry of the Three Musketeers rings aloud in this fantastic tale of adventure and romance. Would he like a sucker? Would he like a sucker? Oh, did he fall down? I'm so sorry. Did you get him? Here's a bottle of water. Will that help? I'm so sorry. Okay. You're welcome. Okay. So back to the adventure of the Three Musketeers. The battle cry of the Three Musketeers rings aloud in this fantastic tale of adventure and romance. Join the young cadet, D'Artagnan, who teams up with the Three Musketeers, Athos, Porthos, and Aramis, as they struggle to save the queen's honor and thwart the evil schemes of powerful Cardinal Richelieu and his murderous spies. And it has some nice illustrations in it. Out. have some similarities to her own life. Which ended very tragically. I'm not going to tell you about that, but you can Google it. She died way too young. She was a great author. Her writing is awesome, in my opinion. And I almost didn't want to put this book down every day. I almost read it in a week because it was really fast reading. But, again, it's a classic, and I always wanted to read that. The Bell Jar chronicles the crack-up of Esther Greenwood, brilliant, beautiful, enormously talented, and successful, but slowly going under, maybe for the last time. Sylvia Plath masterfully draws the reader into Esther's breakdown with such intensity that Esther's insanity becomes completely real and even rational, as probable and accessible an experience as going to the movies. Such deep penetration into the dark and harrowing corners of the psyche is an extraordinary accomplishment and has made The Bell Jar a haunting American classic. There's a picture of her. So those are your books. Which ones did you want? Okay, Moby Dick. Okay. The Bell Jar. And the Three Musketeers. Okay. Alright. Alright, very good. I'll put the others aside. And now for your daughter. What's her name again? Oh, that's a lovely name. I've always loved that name. So beautiful. Okay, so I started with short stories, very short, like one page stories called fables. And I remember my teacher always told me a fable is a story that teaches a lesson or a moral. And here are a few, like the eagle and the crow. It always has animals in it, well, most of the time. The mule. And like I said, they're only a page or a page and a half. The nurse and the wolf. So it's usually titled with one animal or two. You know, you've probably heard of the hare and the tortoise, or the tortoise and the hare, and the lion and the mouse, and city mouse, country mouse. Those are three of my favorites, but I'm not sure if those are in here. I think, let's see, there's quite a few. So, yeah, the lion and the mouse is in here, and country mouse and the town mouse, and yeah, so, and I saw the movie. both excellent. And I think there's different versions of the movie, actually. It's by James Fenimore Cooper, and it's The Last of the Mohicans. So this could be for both of you, again, both you. Do you think you read it in high school?
Yeah.
Okay. It says, a noble friendship. Hawkeye, the colonial scout, and Chingachgook, the Mohican warrior, are brought together by their love of the New World forests and their desire for peace between their races. Set against the exciting days of the French and Indian War, their story, heroically risking their lives to guide two English sisters through hostile territory, battling the evil Les Renards subtil, is a story of how trust and understanding can develop between people of two cultures. Illustrations in here as well. Tell you. captured by a giant. Okay. The BFG is no ordinary bone-crunching giant. He is far too nice and jumbly. It's lucky for Sophie that he is. Had she been carried off in the middle of the night by the blood bottler, the flesh lump eater, the bone cruncher, or any of the other giants, rather than the BFG, she would have soon become breakfast. When Sophie hears that they are flush bunking off to England to swallow a few nice little chitlers, she decides she must stop them once and for all, and the BFG is going to help her. So that's kind of cool. Some illustrations in it, as does the BFG. Up on my calculator here. these up for you. We have a nice reusable tote bag for you with a carry handle. Appreciate your business, and we definitely feel like there's nothing like holding your own book and reading your own book page after page after page. It's just a very satisfying feeling. So thanks for coming in, and I hope you enjoy and your daughter enjoys all of the books. And please to feel free to ask any questions anytime. Give me a call or a call anytime you'd like to order more books. So, all right, thank you so much. Take care.